Hey everyone, 2 weeks ago I launched a video about web components and lit that explains how it works, and a week ago I launched this JavaScript knowledge map where you can see all the things you need to learn about in JavaScript, and when you're logged in you can click on these and it will take you back to the lesson. This video is about something else. In this video I'm going to show you how to implement this share button. If I click on share, it's going to open this modal over here. Now, I already have this modal in my UI component, so I won't be focusing so much on it. But what's nice about this is that when the web share API exists, it's going to use the web share API instead. So if I show this in Safari, click on share, it's going to pull this up. And here's how it looks on my iPhone. If I click on share, it's going to pull up the share sheet. And you will get the same thing on Android. The point of this is just to show you how nice it is to work with lit, which creates web components. And in this video, I'm going to assume you know web components and the basics of lit. So if you don't know that already, you can find the link in the top right corner. So click on it, watch it, and come back. So this one will be a lot more fast paced than the previous one. So yeah, I've just removed this and we're going to code it from scratch. Let's start with its usage. The usage of it will be app share component over here, custom element. I don't have this element yet, so if I reload the screen, you won't see anything. So let's go ahead to components, app.share, index.ts. So I'm going to be writing in TypeScript. So we're going to define a class app.share, and that's going to extend from lit element. This is already imported over here. This is coming from package lit, and lit element itself inherits from HTML element. And then I'm going to do the window.customElements.define or use the custom element decorator, and that's going to register the app share class to the app-share custom element. And this is for TypeScript. Now I'm going to return a render function and return HTML. Again, explanation for this in the previous video, tag template literal. And I'm just going to say app share component here. Reload the page, and yeah, app share component over here. Great. Now let's set up some styles. We define the static get styles, and then we return the styles that we have imported from css.js. I just have a style for the button and for the button active. This is because the component was already coded, but now I'm just emptying it and recoding it myself. So we return the styles over here. The styles will be in a shadow DOM. That's why I'm able to just write button without having to specify an ID or a class. It's just a beautiful joy to write CSS and web components. So now, instead of returning app share component here, I'm going to have an icon for the share. I'm going to write share, and I'm going to get these two over here. I will wrap them with a button because I intend to add a click handler, and that's good for accessibility to have it in a button. This is not a link because it's not taking us to another page. It's not changing the navigation. It's doing an action on the page. And if I reload, it's already styled just because they already have the CSS for it. The one we added with static get styles, you can see over here. Great. Now I've also made this customizable. So if you look here, I have app share color. And if this is not defined, it's going to default to white. But I have defined this on the knowledge map page. So if I do app share color red, yeah, we can customize the color. So I'm going to close the styles. We don't need them anymore. And let's go back here and add an event listener. It's going to be click. I'm going to call the this.share method that we have to define. And over here, we do want to use the navigator.share method. However, this doesn't always exist, and it's not that browsers haven't implemented it on desktop yet. It depends on the operating system, it depends on the device you're running. For example, on a PS4, maybe you'll have it, maybe you won't have it. So with this kind of web API, you always have to check whether it exists or not. So I'm gonna check that share is in navigator. This is gonna return a boolean, and I forgot the if condition. And otherwise, we've got no share. So default to opening a modal, use the web share API. I have GitHub Copilot here, and it's quite nice. So navigator share, and over here we need to define the title, the text, and the URL. You can use window.location.href over here, or you can just hard code it. In my case, it's going to be learn javascript.online/knowledge-map.html. That way, if there are some UTM strings or some other query strings that have been added, they will be removed when you share it. And the text is going to be, check out this interactive JavaScript knowledge map. And the title will be JavaScript knowledge map. Now, it's handy that Safari supports this on the web. Safari on macOS, it doesn't run on other platforms. I mean, it doesn't run on Windows or Linux. So if I click share, if I do messages, you can see, check out this interactive knowledge map and the URL. So depending on which app you choose, you will find out that sometimes use the text, sometimes it uses the title, but the URL, the URL will always be used. Now, before we continue, the goal of this app share element is to make it reusable. So not just for the share map, for the knowledge map, maybe I want to share the course on the homepage, or maybe I want to share a certain lesson. So instead of hard coding these, we want to allow the user, in that case, the developer, in that case, me, to set either an attribute or a property. Since we have just plain strings, I'm going to go with an attribute. So that's going to be the title. It's going to be this one. And the text is going to be this one. And finally, the URL will be this one. So what I'm doing is I'm moving these specific data from inside the component into its usage. I've defined these three attributes. And just for a second, let's reload, go back here, select this. If you want to pass them as properties, then you would have to select this item, and then you could do dot title equals. But as you can see, Lit already converted the attributes into properties. Great. Now, can go back here, and we have to remove these three hard-coded. But first, I have to define the static properties value and say what are the properties that you should expect. We have the title, that is of type string. And before I continue, since I'm using TypeScript, I'm just going to go with the TypeScript syntax. We import property decorator from lit decorators. That's going to be add property and then title. And you can say equals empty string. You can say type string, but that's also the default. It doesn't really matter. Let's duplicate it. It's going to be text and URL. And what this is doing is that it's telling lit that we are expecting an attribute or a property, title, text, and URL. And then it will set them as this.title, this.text, and this.url respectively. We can console log them. Look at this magic. It's amazing. This is GitHub Copilot. Reload and click. You see these three values are being logged. And if I go back to Safari, it still works. But now we can use this AppShare component with different values every time. Great. So we've got the WebShare API use case handled. Now we're going to open the modal. I won't go into the details of the modal because that's a component that I have created on top of the, I think, material design modal component. At this point, I don't really remember, but I just have to have an app modal over here and give it a title. And let's say the title, well, this will be the same as this.title. And let's write some content. This is in the modal. And all I have to do is select the app modal and then call the show method on it. So over here, I need to select the shadow root. However, when using lit, you can use the property render root, which is always guaranteed to be available. Because look, if I do shadow root dot query selector, it's going to warn me that maybe it doesn't exist, because you can decide to say, I don't want a shadow root, even though you should probably never use that. Whereas the render root will always refer either to the shadow root if you have it, or the root of this element if you don't have a shadow DOM. So as a quick recap of this, when using lit, always go with render root because it will always have a value. So I have to find the app modal, and it is possibly null. However, in this case, I kind of guarantee that it is. If it doesn't, I do want it to fail, so I will use the exclamation mark. The open method, so I previously said show, but it should be open. We just need to tell TypeScript that this is the type as app modal. And in this case, I don't need this anymore. And it's actually show not open. Cool, so reload the page. And if I click here, it opens a modal. So again, this may seem like a big jump, but that's the beauty of having a UI kit in your website. It makes things much faster. Once you have an app modal, once you have a button, you can just build features so much faster. So this line is something that I use quite often in my code. There's even a way to use a decorator to get this app modal, but I'm just gonna keep it as is. We are actually almost done. We just need to, so look, this is the title coming from the title property that we passed. This is the content inside of the modal. And if you look at the official one, what we need to pass over here, what we need to display is all of these. I didn't build this myself. This is from sharingbuttons.io, quite like this website. Let's get a URL over here, JavaScript knowledge map, and you select all the social networks that you want. Just for keeping the code short, I'm only gonna select two now, Medium, Circle, and you will get all the HTML and all the CSS. I already have the CSS in my page. I will just copy these, but I do remember that I have made this a bit shorter, so I'm just gonna copy it from my previous code. So share on Facebook, share on Twitter. But now, before I carry on, I do not want to put this over here. I don't want to put it hard-coded here, because what if sometimes I want to have an app share that displays a modal but with something else if the navigator share is not working on this device? So I do want to keep this customizable. And to keep this customizable, I will need to paste this code inside of the app share. So this is like the fallback. When the navigator share doesn't exist, I will say this is the fallback here. And my goal is to take all the content over here and inject it in the app modal. And this is actually really easy. It's called a slot. So all the content over here that is in the light DOM will be injected in the slot element. And now if I reload the page, yeah, it still works. So that means I can go over here. Instead of this paragraph, I can paste all of these styles and close the div. And this will be used as a fallback if the navigator share was not working in the browser. So click, now I have this. The styles are a bit messed up, but that's okay. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I really love the simplicity of web components and Lit. It doesn't take so long to do most of the use cases, and yeah, it's pretty neat. You can also have multiple slots. You can give them names, but this is the use case that I have. It was a real use case, so I've coded this last week, and now I coded it again in front of you. Oh yeah, and don't forget to check out the knowledge map. It's linked below. If you're learning JavaScript, that's gonna help you a lot orienting yourself, like because this is actually a progress bar. It's not visible because I'm a localhost, but the more lessons you continue, the more the progress bar will start filling. And also once you complete lessons, you'll be able to click on them and then go back to their original lesson. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know if you have any questions, and I'll see you in the next one.